the tape for this, our first fight on the main card on CBS Sports Network. 1 inch taller is Taylor Guardado. And like you said, Megan, coming in about 2 pounds over that 135-pound limit, she will also enjoy a 6-inch reach advantage. And now, ready to make the official introduction, here is Joe Martinez.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here we go from Memorial Hall here in Kansas City, Kansas. Welcome to Invicta FC, Bernardo versus Ruben. And all fight fans, we are set to go 3 rounds this schedule in the bantamweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, this mixed martial artist stands 5 feet 5 inches tall, weighing in officially 135.5 pounds in 12 fights. Her record stands at 8 victories with 4 defeats. Fighting out of Chiba, Japan, here is Yoko Higashi. And across the cage, her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a striker standing 5 feet 6 inches tall. She weighed in over the bantamweight limit, 137.5 pounds. In 6 fights, her record stands at 4 victories with 2 defeats. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, here is Taylor Guardado! And your referee in charge of the action, Nick Behrens.
Taylor Guardado absolutely stared down Yoko Higashi. The intensity in that ring right now for the first fight of the main card. And here we go. Round one. Set for 3 5-minute rounds. Guardado opening up with big strikes early.
Ooh.
Look at that misdirection.
Just completely flung her into the fence. That's the problem with overcommitting. You can see that in some of Yoko's fights. She does kind of reach for some of those takedowns.
Yeah, it's almost like she's overcompensating to be able to close the range.
Oh!
That takedown, you're like, oh my goodness.
Don't blink, ladies and gentlemen.
Guardado is a powerhouse, and something she said coming into this fight is, you know, her last fight, she didn't have a lot of confidence. She wasn't feeling a lot of confidence. Now she feels like herself. She feels that confidence, and she wants to show it tonight.
Leg kick lands on the outside.
Again, there's that shot from too far away there.
What a scroll by Guardado. That was beautiful. Immediately looking to take the back. She has a knee in on the left side. Doesn't look like she has a hook on the right.
Tough spot for Yoko Higashi early on in the fight.
She got both hooks in now. This is great positioning for Taylor Guardado.
Oh, she's in her knee. She's in the chin. And that's it. Taylor Guardado with her naked choke submission. What a statement.
Oh my goodness. Did she even get hit?
I don't think so.
What a performance for Guardado. Landing strikes early, stuffing the takedown, and not just that, but immediately circling around to the back, sinks in the rear naked choke. Now she is on a 2-fight win streak. Here's a replay.
You can see she sprawls out, spins around, gets that underhook. She's looking to get her feet hooked in as well. But what she does very well here is when she gets the opportunity, she really gets that ground and pound in. I think one of those was the back of the head, but those others were right on the ear. And as she is punching, she slips that left arm underneath the chin, the Japanese fighter, and secures the tap.
And that's a big victory for Guardado as well. Yoko Higashi comes in, the former Deep Jewels featherweight champion. And that's another feather in the cap for the experienced Taylor Guardado. And now we'll be right back after this break with the official decision. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Here's Joe Martinez with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Renegade Choke submission comes at the official time. 1 minute, 23 seconds. Round number one for your winner, Taylor Guardado.
I'm here with your winner, Taylor. Girl, you did not come to play tonight. You were getting paid by the second, it looks like. Was that the game plan coming in tonight, being aggressive right off the bat?
Yeah, in my interview before the fight, I had said that I think that my striking was going to make her take a desperate shot, and I was going to capitalize off of that, and I did exactly what I said I would do. But I did want to apologize to Yoko, Invicta, Shannon Knapp, my team. I did everything right this camp. I have no excuses. I just missed weight for the first time in my life, and I plan to never do it again.
Well, I know you've kind of flitted between 145 and 135, and 135 is where you said that you wanted to continue going with your career. Do you have a name in mind on who you want to fight next? Do you have your eye on the title? Where do you feel like you lie right now in the bantamweight division?
I think I'm one of the best in the bantamweight division, just to be honest with you. I don't really have a name or anything next, but I'm willing for any challenge. I'm always down for a good challenge.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, give it up